Today we're going to talk about the Constitution, or at least how Elon Musk sees it. Just a couple hours ago, the third person to win $1 million was announced in Pennsylvania. Tesla CEO Elon Musk is unlawfully giving away money to support, and I quote, defending the Constitution. So this is a trend, and it's called Republican constitutionalism. So when you see those We the People shirts, or, you know, I stand for the Constitution, or I'm a constitutionalist, or I'm not an American, I'm a constitutionalist, or, you know, it very quickly can become, I want to separatism, right? You want to leave America and become your own little thing. Very typical sort of bullshit. We're getting into QAnon, we're getting into, you know, all of that. So Republican constitutionalism, by definition, is when the lawfulness of the laws themselves are upheld to the, in quote, highest standard, often against the societal desires of the group, okay?
That's not a pretty sight.
A favorite constitutionalist platform is defending the right to bear arms, or to bear AK-47s. Did you know that AK-47s can be purchased for as little as $10 in some places, and for under $300 in most places? It's also less accurate than other assault rifles of the mid-1940s. Did you know that AK-47s also shoot 600 rounds per minute? And you wonder why people want gun reform. Elon Musk has thrown his weight behind former President Trump and the Republican Party, describing Trump as the only candidate to, in quote, preserve democracy in America.
I mean, it just gets more unbelievable sometimes.
You can say that again. Tim Walz was just quoted saying this.
Like a dipshit.
Sorry, wrong clip. He was saying this.
Look, Elon's on that stage, jumping around, skipping like a dipshit on these things. You know it.
Walz went on to talk about J.D. Vance, who is recently being quoted saying that Trump did indeed lose the election, but not before it was stolen from him. Yeah. Sorry, wrong clip.
But look, I'm not going to waste all the time I'm in. I'm going to talk about his running mate. His running mate, Elon Musk. Seriously. Where is Senator Vance after he got asked the simplest question in the world at the debate? Did Donald Trump lose the 2020 election? And after 2 weeks, he finally said, no, he didn't. That's where he's been spending his time. But that's it. So
that's who I want for my vice president. Someone that ignores domestic terrorism and has sexual relationships with furniture. That's not the only time that Tim Walz has said a few things about J.D. Vance.
I got to tell you, pointing out just an observation of mine that I made. I just have to say it. You know it. You feel it. These guys are creepy and, yes, just weird as hell. That's what you see. That's what you see. He mocks our laws. He sows chaos and division. And that's to say nothing of his record as president. He froze in the face of the COVID crisis. He drove our economy into the ground. And make no mistake, violent crime was up under Donald Trump. That's not even counting the crimes he committed.
I love Tim Walz. I think he's awesome. I think he's an incredible masculine energy for this country. He's kind and he's straightforward, but he's also a ball buster, and I appreciate that about him. Imagine a world where voting comes with a $1 million prize. That's right, Elon Musk, the same guy who shot a car into space and named his child after a Wi-Fi password, is now paying Americans to register to vote. And it's not just any old prize. Oh no, it's $1 million for the lucky voter. So you might be thinking, that's 346 million Americans, Elon. However, will you pay us? Oh, I didn't mention it was only swing states. You don't see Elon Musk offering this deal to voters in like Wyoming or Vermont. No offense to those states, but we all know those electoral votes are more locked in than a toddler on his iPad and family vacation.
That's not a pretty sight.
Swing states have always been the belle of the electoral ball, and Elon, like some sort of futuristic Robin Hood, is throwing a little tech billionaire glitter on it. But let's be honest, you get a chance at $1 million, suddenly the ballot box never looks sexier. But can we talk about how Elon has the strategy as all the subtlety of a guy with a Lamborghini trying to impress a first date? Like, hey, baby, democracy is important and all, but like, here's some money? Anyway, that didn't stop Elon from feigning innocence as all diabolical villains do.
The stakes are super high. You know, fortunately, more and more people are sort of, you know, coming out of the closet, you know, type of thing. Like, so like saying this for Trump, it's like, you know, it's like, maybe it's probably the most rebellious thing you could do in San Francisco, but it's like, you know, by a long shot. So, you know, that's, anyway, I'm not a natural politician, nor do I wish to be. I just want to make, you know, cool technology that you'll love to use. So, all right.
I'll show you some technology I'd like to use. People should stick to what they know. Musk with technology, Trump destroying the free world.
That's not a pretty sight.
Elon Musk's rallies were not the only thing happening in Pennsylvania. Donald Trump recently talked about Arnold Palmer's junk, which I covered in a previous story. Then he went to the Pittsburgh Steelers game. Trump's perfect weekend, spandex and dick. I'm sorry, that was the street. Outside the stadium, not the stadium itself. Notice all the grannies with their middle fingers up? American democracy.
USA! USA! USA!
This is yet again another example of how out of touch with reality Trump is. The crowd is booing him. There's more footage of that coming up, but you can see him in the, whatever, the glove compartment, the, what do they call them, box seats. Those seats, and they, you know, he's like cheering on, and you know, most of the stadium is booing him though, as you'll see in the next clip.
Get him out of town!
Honestly, I haven't heard a chorus of boos that loud since Trump tried to explain how windmills cause cancer. Even the refs were like, whoa, buddy, enough is enough. But you gotta hand it to Trump. Showing up to a football game where 99% of the crowd thinks you belong in the penalty box for, I don't know, talking about dick, is gutsy. It's delusional. But gutsy.
That's not a pretty sight.
You know it's bad when the stadium that's dealt with Ben Roethlisberger's passes for the last, oh God, I don't know, they're booing you out of the stadium. The Steelers fan base is not fair weather. They are ride or die. So for you to get booed out, I mean, that's really saying something. He probably walked into Pennsylvania not giving a shit. You know, Trump walks in with the seat of his pants. I got a semblance of a plan. This was the man that dodged the draft because of, in quote, bone spurs. He got sacked and bodied before fucking halftime. He probably came into Pennsylvania like, step aside. They'll love me here. They love the Steelers, not the guy that tossed this country like an interception. This has been really American. Please, please vote blue November 5th. I'm Jasmine Meadows. We'll be right back.